Exposed to Duterte's crazy antics, Filipinos had better expect bizarre twists of his lunacy. This early he must lay the ground for his minions to assume power to save his ass. How? On December 6, 2019, he sent his Labor Secretary Silvestre Bello III to negotiate for the end time to resume peace negotiation with the Reds in the Netherlands. Aware of the Reds' old and recurring style using negotiation as ruse to fortify and strengthen their rebel activities, De Gaulle, through Bello, should present to the NDF leadership a tacit agenda. Let's have a mutual proposition here and get away from the charade peace talks. I can provide your needs for your revolution. In return, laid back from creating mob scenarios, instigating chaos reminiscent of your Plaza Miranda bombing of the 70s. Duterte and the NPA are friends. In Davao, they feed each other's needs. Sanctuary. The NPA can roam around undisturbed, in exchange no launching of direct confrontation between them. People's hatred for Dutch multiplied. It's getting untenable every day. The NPA and the NDFs dipping to the smoldering firestorm could enhance his downfall. Expected People's Power Tree predicted. Most Filipino insinuated that sweet flowing of drug money attributed to the 7 hours blitz of the 2018 midterm election. It's the people's belief that the recent COMELEC voter turnout decimated the Ocho Derecho. As the power of drug money can lure everyone, Duterte's minions can assure of a landslide victory come 2020 presidential election. So, to replicate the mishaps of the Ocho Derecho, drug money must now do a hocus-pocus in the 20 election. And that's easy. Two Bureau of Customs Chief Nicanor P. Eldon and Isidro La Peña, under their noses, had slipped through customs shabu shipment worth multi-billion pesos. It is easy to speculate that the same incident will occur. Enormous funds to buy out election results are assured. The strategy is repeatable because those previous customs chief just moved to another post.